Good morning, Granada. I'm Kaylee.
And I'm Tiffany, but y'all could call me Tiff. And this is your morning El Aviso for Wednesday, April 24th.
Last week during the Boston Marathon, two homemade bombs exploded after nearly 27,000 runners had crossed the finish line. Three people were killed and more than 140 were injured. After looking through pictures and surveillance footage from the marathon, authorities discovered two suspects. The two suspects are brothers, ages 19 and 26. The older brother was killed while the other one was on the run. Boston was on lockdown as they searched for the younger brother. They finally captured him and now he is in the hospital in critical condition. He continues to be unable to speak but has communicated by writing on paper. There are more details to come.
Hey guys, STAR testing begins today. Testing begins at 8:30 each day. Classes meet after testing. Refer to the bell schedule for each day's classes and times.
Our participation in the STAR test helps determine our Academic Performance Index, API, that is the state of California's measurement of our academic success. Granada's API is 846 and has improved each year since 2007. Let's keep up the great work by getting good night's rest and eating a healthy breakfast before testing.
State standardized testing is starting soon.
Here are some tips to make your test experience the best it can be.
Make sure you get a good night's sleep the day before testing days.
The night before a big test is not the time to stay up late watching TV.
Eat a good healthy breakfast the day of the test.
It will be hard for you to concentrate if you're hungry and your stomach is growling.
Try to make your morning at home relaxed and stress-free.
The day of an important test is not the day to oversleep or start a fight with your little brother.
Get to school with plenty of time to spare on testing days.
And don't be late to school.
If you have something like a dentist appointment scheduled for testing days,
see if you could possibly reschedule it.
But the most important thing to remember during testing is...
do your best. Try your hardest.
Give 100% effort.
Good luck!
You know what, guys? I think we need a break. Here's Chats with Max.
So, if you guys could make any flavor lollipop, what would it be?
Mocha.
Sherbet. Popcorn.
Pancakes.
It would be elk on the outside with caribou on the inside and chewy.
Justice. Just justice. The flavor of justice.
It would be spiced ketchup.
A mustard flavored lollipop with a ketchup core.
Ketchup core?
Yeah.
What inspired that?
I like mustard and ketchup.
Cookie dough, vanilla.
Cotton candy.
Mashed potatoes on the inside and gravy on the outside.
Ham bone.
Sour apple.
What inspired that?
His idea.
Water flavor.
Probably nacho cheese outer with bacon inside.
It'd be like gravy with like cornbread in the center, because it'd just be like amazing. You just like eat gravy all day and like lollipops, that'd be freaking awesome.
Probably have to be strawberry cake with strawberries in it and strawberry frosting with strawberries.
Barbecue. Just barbecue sauce, that's it. That's all you need, dude.
What about like the inner though, the inner core of the lollipop?
Just
the heart of it.
Sauce. Just pure barbecue sauce.
Nutella. I'll do peanut butter with Rice Krispie in the middle.
A peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Probably a meatball sub.
Pineapple, because I love pineapples and I think everyone knows that.
What would be on the inside of that though?
On the inside? Pineapple.
Catalyst SAT Boot Camp will be at Granada High School from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. this Saturday, April 27th, and Sunday, April 28th. Students attend both days. You need to enroll by 6 p.m. today. The cost is $165.
The Class of 2013 Senior Ball is Saturday, June 8th, from 6 p.m. to 11 p.m. Buy your ticket early and save money. Prices go up May 8th. Tickets include a three-course dinner with a choice of prime rib, chicken, or a vegetarian entree. Pre-sale tickets are sold today through May 7th for $80 with ASB or $85 without ASB. Regular tickets will be sold May 8th through May 29th and will be $90 with ASB and $95 without.
I'm Luis.
And I'm Mr. Hahn, and this is your weekly sports report.
Last week on Tuesday, our boys volleyball team took on Foothill. They had a rough patch in the beginning and began to pull things together in the preceding set, but still couldn't get away with the win. Girls lacrosse played Foothill, losing 6-2, and then varsity softball beat Carnelette 6-4. Great job, ladies.
On Wednesday, our baseball team played De La Salle and won 4-0. To keep their 15-game win streak going, come check out their next game and support our Granada baseball boys in the road to NCS. Thursday, our softball team played Monta Vista, but sadly lost 3-0.
Last Friday, our boys baseball team played Monta Vista. Boys volleyball played Monta Vista and won due to a forfeit. Boys lacrosse went up against Cal, and our diving and swim team played De La Salle / Carondelet.
Last Saturday, our volleyball team had a huge tournament at Cal. A couple of weeks ago, our boys lacrosse played Foothill and won in double overtime. The score was 14-13, and they once again won in double overtime after Amador High School, which in a result was 16-15. If you want to see a great, intense game, come check out our boys lacrosse, which is undefeated in Ebol right now.
In upcoming sports, tonight our baseball team plays our crosstown rivals, Livermore High School. Varsity at home, while JV and Frosh at Livermore. Girls lacrosse at Carondelet, 5:30 and 6:30.
Tomorrow, boys golf plays the Cowboys at Livermore at 3:30, softball versus Santa Road at 4 o'clock, track and field at Foothill, and 4 o'clock we have boys volleyball at De La Salle, JV at 5 and varsity at 6.
Friday, boys baseball plays San Ramon and swimming and diving at Monta Vista.
And Saturday, boys lacrosse plays De La Salle.
And here's Javon with Player of the Week.
Good morning, Granada. I'm Javon, and I'm here with Casey Soltis, our new Player of the Week. So, Casey, as an individual player, what do you do to keep your team running?
I just try to go out every day and play my hardest to help our team get a win.
So, everybody at Granada knows that our baseball team right now is ranked. How does that make you feel as an individual?
It doesn't really mean anything to us until we have the NCS trophy.
I'm pretty sure you know where you want to be after high school, and where would that be?
I'm committed right now to the University of Oregon.
Thank you, Casey.
Thank you.
Tune in next week, Granada, for your new Player of the Week.
Hey, Granada.
If you want to see a new player for the Player of the Week segment,
tweet at us with their sport and name at @GHS_studio.
Attention, seniors. Do you need money for college? Make sure you are visiting the Career Center for your scholarship opportunities. All scholarship applications can be picked up in the Career Center and must be submitted to Miss Mintz by May 6th. Again, that is May 6th.
Leadership Day took place last Tuesday, April 16th. Here are some of the highlights.
Awesome. We're going to learn a lot of new things, and you guys are going to have a class of the day. So,
alright, basically, it's like working towards a goal, even with obstacles and like difficulties ahead of you. So, to begin, I'm going to do a little icebreaker.
Is there not a dress code in this school or something?
Nope.
I've never seen so many damn ears in my life. Look at all the Mickey Mouse's, how fun. Yep, it's true, I am here to take
A big thank you to all that attended. Also, a huge thank you to Cheyenne Pico for organizing the event and making Leadership Day 2013 an unforgettable experience.
Attention AP students, if you have registered to take an AP exam, you need to attend a mandatory AP pre-administration meeting this week in the student union. If your last name starts with a P through Z, you are meeting tomorrow at 3:10 p.m. Again, that is 3:10 p.m. if your last name starts with a P through Z. Hey guys, I'm Tiff with my homegirl, Kay Dizzle.
Kaylee.
Kay Dizzle.
Have a great day, Granada.